clearly somebody isn't doing their job. Because if we're talking about, I would have to say, more than 1,000 foreign nationals, mostly of Chinese ethnicity, coming from mainland China, who are working in a gambling hub, and only 300 are registered, it doesn't add up. Who isn't doing their job?
Well, as I said, first of all, PAGCOR needs to have a list of all of their employees. Why? Because all employees working inside IGLs or the former POGOS needs to have an online gaming employee license.
Okay. Yeah, no? But clearly they don't have a list. They don't have a list of everyone.
Yes, they do have a list, but not of everyone. So I think there is, PAGCOR has a lot of explaining to do in relation to that OGEL, of course. I've been saying this, and we've been saying this in different public fora. We're friends with PAGCOR, but then again, they have too much in their hands. I don't think they're able to fully regulate or properly regulate even these 43 licensed IGLs. They need to do more. They need to do more. And of course, they need to properly coordinate the Bureau of Immigration. These two agencies obviously don't talk a lot, obviously. Because the records do not match up. The records don't add up.
Okay. Well, the need to do more is a bit of an understatement. In these POGO hubs, what have you discovered? Prostitution, torture. What else have you discovered? Crypto scams, shopping scams, love scams, right?
Yeah. Yes, yes. A good number of organized criminal activities are linked to this online gaming, offshore gaming operation. So at some point, all of us have to sit in one room and come up with an executive policy that we could recommend as one body to the chief executive.
Okay, sir, the last time I spoke with you, you already said you should sit in one room and dialogue. That must have been, I think, last week. You haven't sat in one room yet?
Obviously not yet. No. We've been having meetings left and right. No, but at the end of the day, we don't seem to agree on a single recommendation. Personally, I've sat in a good number of meetings, and we have yet to come up with one policy recommendation that we fully agree on and bring before the president and bring before the executive secretary, so to speak. So this question needs to be settled fairly soon, because our people are waiting for an answer as to what we would do what the executive branch would do in relation to this problem.
Yeah. Okay, I guess my last question, sir, is no doubt it's the PAOK that's been taking the lead. It's the PAOK that's been exposing the illegal activities of the POGO hubs. But then again, you're filing cases, but are you satisfied with the breadth and the depth? Essentially, I mean, these cases, for example, you have Mayor Alice Goh. The Senate's determined she's actually not Filipino, but she's completely Chinese. So she shouldn't be sitting as a public official. But that's one issue. But the cases that you are filing against the Bamban Hub, the Porak Hub, are you satisfied?
Not yet, Karen. In fact, there are other cases that would be filed eventually against the incorporators, officers, and beneficial owners of Bamban and Porak. As to are we satisfied? Not yet. We're taking it one case at a time. We filed one major case. So we're hoping and expecting the OSG to file the co-warranto case against the mayor. Likewise, the OSG to finally cancel her birth certificate, her spurious birth certificate. Likewise, we're waiting for the Anti-Money Laundering Council to file the necessary money laundering case against her. So a good number of cases will be filed against Gu Huaping and the other incorporators and beneficial owners of these bogus scam hubs. Now, bear in mind, Karen, a major component of these operations are in relation to scamming. So we'd have to finish the digital forensic examinations of all of the digital devices that you would present as evidence in court. Mm. Once we do that, we would be able to file the necessary cases in relation to violations of the Securities and Regulation Code, Consumer Protection Act, and other investment scam-related cases.
Okay. All right. Now, I think within the week, what are you planning? What is PAOK planning this week?
This afternoon, if I'm not mistaken, this afternoon or tomorrow morning, we'll be able to file the initial cases of kidnapping and serious illegal detention against some perpetrators of PORAC, of the PORAC scam farm.
But
remember, Karen,
but you haven't found them. You're filing cases.
They are.
Okay.
They are. Two of the perpetrators are in our custody. A good number of the persons of interest in relation to PORAC are with us. So we're developing, we're doing case build up against them. But okay. You are correct. You are correct, Karen. A good number of the big bosses are still out there, but we're catching them one at a time.
All right. Now, my last question, I want to add this. I don't know exactly what the law is in China, but I know gambling is illegal. I don't know if it's life imprisonment or the death penalty, but what are the rules? Let's say, so clearly you've arrested Chinese nationals without papers who are involved in gambling, which China finds illegal, by the way. Pogo is illegal in China. What has the Department of Foreign Affairs said? Are we mandated to deport them and they be tried and heard there? Or are they tried here and they are, if found guilty, kept here?
Okay. Those foreign nationals with whom we have criminal evidence to charge them criminally, we charge them here. We've charged a good number of them already here. In most of the in all of these scam farms that we've raided, we've kept a good number of the foreign nationals here, and a good number of them are locked in jail. Now, the rest, on whom we could not file criminal charges due to lack of material time or due to lack of evidence on hand, they're deported in China. But once they're deported in China, they're received by their police there and they're incarcerated. Most, if not, a good number of all of those that we have deported since September of last year are still in jail in China.
Okay. On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today. As always, sir, you have a good and, I guess, productive week ahead. Thank you so much. PAOK spokesperson Winston Casio. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Karen.